It's the Southeastern Conference Basketball Tournament. Live from the Civic Center in Birmingham, Alabama. Tonight's championship game, Kentucky versus Tennessee. This game is brought to you by Pabst Blue Ribbon. Pabst is brewed to be the best, naturally, with no artificial ingredients. And you can taste it. And by Datsun, who invites you to see the awesome 280 ZX Motor Trends Import Car of the Year. And by Hardee's. Hardee's, best eaten in town, up and down, and all around.
By the First Federal Savings and Loan Association of Madisonville. By Wendy's Old Fashioned Hamburgers. And by the Amex Coal Company.
And a very pleasant good evening to you. Here in Birmingham, it has been raining all day. Tonight, we expect basketballs to be raining through the hoops here. Jay Randolph to call the play-by-play of the SEC final tonight alongside the former Duke All-American, who will analyze the action for us, Jeff Mullins, and courtside, our good friend from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, a gentleman who will be analyzing for us down there, John Ferguson. Tonight, Kentucky, the Wildcats, and Tennessee going at it for the championship. It has been the first renewal of this tournament in 27 years. It has been something very special, a happening.
It certainly has, Jay. 3 days ago, we had 10 teams in this tournament. Now we're down to two, Kentucky and Tennessee. Kentucky, a young team, finished sixth during the regular season, but they've played remarkably well, despite the fact they've played four games in 6 days, despite the fact they had a key injury last night to Dwight Anderson, despite the fact they only have 8 scholarship athletes, they're in the final game. Tennessee, on the other hand, showed what they were made of last night. They came into the tournament with a 6-game win streak, a second-place finish, and a bye, and last night they beat a stubborn Auburn team. We've got our ball game tonight.
Right now, down on the court, the color guard is coming onto the floor here at the Civic Center in Birmingham, Alabama. Our pregame ceremonies are getting underway, and with you, we'll join and watch these opening ceremonies. Two outstanding teams playing for the championship here tonight. Jay Randolph along with Jeff Mullins with you. Hope you're going to enjoy it wherever you are. Some outstanding individuals, Jeff, in this tournament.
Yes, we do, and we have some interesting matchups. At the forward position, Chuck Verderber will be guarded by Carter tonight, who Verderber will have about 4 inches. I look perhaps for Kentucky to maybe take advantage of that. On the other hand, defensively, Tennessee will match Crosby up against the hot Kyle Macy. Crosby's a strong player, has done a good job on Kyle in the past, so those are two very interesting matchups.
The starting lineups for tonight's championship game. First of all, for Kentucky, number 34, 6'6", freshman, Chuck Verderber. For Tennessee, number 25, 6'4", senior, Terry Crosby. For Kentucky, number 52, 6'6", junior, LaVon Williams. Number 32 for Tennessee, 6'9", junior, Reggie Johnson. Number 40 for Kentucky, 6'8", sophomore, Fred Cowan. Number 44 for Tennessee, 6'7", sophomore, Howard Wood. For Kentucky, number 22, 6'1", senior, Truman Clater. Number 10 for Tennessee, 6'3", junior, Bert Bertelkamp. For Kentucky, number 4, a junior, 6'3", Kyle Macy. And for Tennessee, number 30, 6'3", freshman, Gary Carter. The coaches for Kentucky, Joe B. Hall. For Tennessee, Don DeVoe. Ladies and gentlemen, tossing out the ball for the first championship game of the Southeastern Conference Basketball Tournament in 27 years is Georgia Athletic Director Joel Eaves. Not only did Eaves play in the Southeast Conference while a three-sport athletic man at Auburn, he later coached in the Southeastern Conference Tournament. He's a member of the Sports Hall of Fame in both Alabama and Georgia. In addition, he brought the first Mideast Regional Playoffs as well as the NCAA Basketball Finals to the Deep South. And he's received the National Association of Basketball Coaches National Award for his contributions to basketball. Joel Eaves, there you see him along the center stripe. A great gentleman. And we are awaiting the toss of the ball as these two teams come out. He passes that ball out to Paul Galvin, one of our three officials, who comes in and shakes hands with him. This has been quite a week of basketball. After 27 years, this tournament being renewed, we have two outstanding teams, and we are ready to go.
Jay, as we approach the toss, one thing to consider again tonight is this Kentucky team has played four in a row. Fatigue will have to be a factor. Look for Tennessee to up the tempo of this game.
Reggie Johnson will jump for Tennessee. Fred Cowan for Kentucky. We're underway. Ball belongs to Tennessee. The other officials, you saw Paul Galvin, are Don Shea and Ben Dunn. Tennessee 19 and 11, Kentucky 19 and 10. This is Bertelkamp.
Kentucky opening in a man-to-man defense tonight.
Shot put up by Terry Crosby. Rebounded away by Williams. Here is Clater for Kentucky. The Wildcats will go left to right here in the first half. The third night in a row, they're playing in their dark blue road uniforms. Macy. This is Clater. Clater gets it away.
Truman Clater starting right where he left off in this tournament, shooting the outside shot, getting the first two for Kentucky.
Clater has scored 57 points in three games. Add two to that, he now has 59. Wood in underneath for Tennessee. Tapped up, Terry Crosby.
Exactly what Kentucky coach Joe Hall doesn't want to happen. Oh, what a great layup.
Herderber missing the layup as he went in underneath.
Very alert play by the Kentucky team. Herderber had a good layup, just laid it up a little bit too strong, missed the basket.
It'll be Kentucky's ball. No foul on the play. There was a little contact there. Clater getting it out. Cowan off to Macy. Macy banks it up and he's fouled. Macy fouled by Wood. Or was it called?
Macy was called for the offensive foul.
Offensive foul on Macy.
Driving into that middle area, he got a little bit out of control.
Joe Hall, 50 years old, Cynthiana, Kentucky, is home. Shot put up in underneath by Gary Carter, and a foul call.
I had occasion to talk to Coach Don DeVoe of Tennessee, and he said it's very important for Tennessee to win the battle of the boards. That time they were called going over the back, trying to get to the offensive boards.
Reggie Johnson charged for the foul. Kyle Macy on the move. Herderber gives it back to Macy, and a try for the steal.
Matchup early in this game, as we mentioned. Gary Crosby, strong player guarding Kyle Macy, a quick guard. Going to be very key in this game how these two players get off early.
Clater getting it out. Clater guarded by Bertelkamp, and a foul on Bertelkamp.
The other interesting matchup as we talked in the open has Gary Carter guarding Chuck Herderber. Herderber about 6'6 and a half, Carter 6'3, so Kentucky may try to take advantage of that mismatch.
Bertelkamp batting it out of bounds.
Kentucky being very deliberate on offense, taking their time. They don't want this team to get out of control.
pass into Cowan for two. Beautiful play.
Sideline, out of bounds play. A back pick on Cowan's man. Cowan got the high lob and a dunk shot. Two more for Kentucky.
Bertelkamp on the move against Macy. Macy kicked the ball. It'll belong to Tennessee. We're in the opening moments here. The championship game, the NCAA bid goes to the winner.
I think Tennessee may be surprised by this man-to-man defense. I saw them practice today, and they were practicing primarily against the zone, knowing that Kentucky played almost zone almost exclusively last night.
Bertelkamp making a good move. The fall-away jumper is off, and it is Macy for Kentucky. Macy a long pass to Clater. Clater's 20-footer. Yes!
Exactly where he got hot from the other 2 days. He likes that left-hand corner. That was a long shot, a very difficult shot.
Bertelkamp getting it off to Crosby. Crosby working against Minerva. Off to Bertelkamp, banks it up. Nice play. They worked well on that one.
Good two-on-two play. Alert pass by Crosby. Nice shot by Bertelkamp.
6-4 Kentucky. We played almost 3 minutes of this first half. LeVon Williams getting it out to Bederber. Off to Clater. Bank it up and in. Clater has 6 points here in the early going.
3 for 3 from the floor, all from the outside.
Now they warm to their task, Tennessee and Kentucky. Kurt Bertelkamp out front.
Kentucky back in the zone now, changing their defense.
Crosby for the Vols. Tough shooting lock in and out. Minerva rebounded, lost it, a foul. On number 32 of Tennessee, Reggie Johnson. That is his second. Fouls could be very important. Obviously, that is a factor in any game. But when you're down to the nub, it's really rough.
In one of the Tennessee-Kentucky games this year, Johnson got in foul trouble very early and only played about 15 minutes. However, Tennessee still won, but it is a key factor.
Pass goes into Cowan, out to Clater. Clater's in trouble, got it into LeVon Williams, and a foul called in the lane. That's the fourth team foul against Tennessee. It is charged to Carter. That's his first. We have 16:25 to play. We're in the first half with Jeff Mullins. This is Jay Randolph at the Civic Center in Birmingham. SEC final. Bederber, the freshman, trying to make a move, is fouled by Howard Wood. That's number one on Wood.
Again, they called an offensive foul on Bederber that time, and Coach Joe Hall was asking a question about that.
I had to question it, too. I thought, sure, the foul was on Wood, but Bederber commits his first. Team foul number two against Kentucky.
Kentucky Carter. Back in that 1-3-1 that worked so effectively last night for them.
Carter shooting and hitting. Gary Carter. He's just a freshman from Johnson City, Tennessee. He has his first field goal. It's 8-6 Kentucky. Put up by Cowan. Fred Cowan, 4 points.
Cowan has been a very fine player for Kentucky thus far in the tournament, scoring 29 points, but at key times.
Howard Wood with a turnaround jumper. Wood has his first field goal. We're going to have a timeout. We have 15:33 left to play in this first half. The Wildcats on top of Tennessee here, 10-8. This telecast is presented by authority of the Southeastern Conference and the C.D. Chesley Company. Any use of this program without the written consent of the Chesley Company prohibited. The announcers on this program have been approved and contracted for by the C.D. Chesley Company. Kentucky, Jeff, shooting 83% in the early going, hitting 5 out of 6. Tennessee, 4 out of 9 for 45%. And the Wildcats have really been going good in their shooting here in this tournament.
That time Kyle Macy dribbled down the left-hand side of the floor. His patented move in this tournament looked like he might isolate himself with Crosby one-on-one. Crosby reached in, called for the foul before the shot.
And it is the first on Crosby and the 15th foul against Tennessee. Kentucky has hit 100 out of 165 field goals in three games, and they're really hot. That's Clater again. Clater now with 8 points.
Excellent one-on-one move by Clater. They had isolated that side of the floor. He had confidence. He made the shot.
LaVon Williams batted it away. Macy comes back. Off it goes. Up and in. Fred Cowan has 6 points. 14-8.
Kyle Macy has yet to score a point, but we see how valuable he is just in his leadership for this Kentucky team.
Bertelkamp trying to settle the Volunteers down just a bit. Lost out of bounds by Carter. 14 minutes and 46 seconds left to play. We're in the first half here.
Kentucky didn't stay in that man-to-man defense very long.
Carter puts it up. Carter has 4 points.
Carter and Crosby, Jay, are the two keys for Tennessee against the zone. They're their good outside shooters. Last night, they did a good job at it.
Verderber, the freshman, getting it back out to Cowan. Shovel shot, LaVon Williams tapping it in. Williams has his first field goal.
Excellent follow-up by LaVon Williams. Very alert play. Clater drove to the basket, threw the defensive man to him. Williams took up the shot, tipped it in.
16-10, Kentucky by half a dozen. Crosby. Crosby has four. These two clubs coming out hot.
Yes, they are, and Crosby and Carter picking up where they left off last night, hitting the outside shot.
Macy getting it to Verderber, off to Clater. Clater driving against Bertelkamp, is foul. A foul on Bertelkamp. His second.
Not a great shot by Clater that time, but he's got his confidence. He felt like he could go up. Bertelkamp was all over him. However, he landed on him as he went up to block the shot.
Truman Clater, the senior from Toledo, Ohio, born in Ashland, Kentucky. Shooting two. Clater, a 74.4% free throw shooter, averaging 7.9 a game. He was 9-for-9 in the second half against Alabama in Kentucky's 101-100 victory.
That was a great shooting exhibition. None of those were layups. Another interesting thing thus far in the game, Reggie Johnson has yet to touch the ball for the University of Tennessee. Kentucky doing a good job defensively keeping the ball away from him.
Trying to get it in underneath to Reggie Johnson, and Kentucky coming away again. That is two turnovers against Tennessee. 13 minutes and 10 seconds to play in the first half. Kentucky leading 18-12. Ball went out of bounds off Crosby. There is Dwight Anderson, the brilliant freshman for Kentucky, who is out of action with that broken left wrist. He did it just 23 seconds into the game here last night. Clater missing. Tennessee on the run.
End of the semi-fast break. Great pass by Carter into Johnson, and he stuffed it home.
Macy from 20. Macy gets it back. Rebound to Howard Wood of Tennessee, covering up. 12 and a half to play in the first half. Bertelkamp. That shot put up by Crosby.
Excellent follow-up by Carter. He was in the right place at the right time, showed what a great athlete he is, staying up in the air and laying it in the basket.
Carter will be a very important cog if Tennessee is to win this game. 18-16, the balls have come back. Cowan goes to the hoop.
What a fine tournament he has had, and he plays with it facing the basket so well, driving to the hoop time after time.
Bertelkamp. Last night he missed four shots from the field, but he looked good there. Joe Hall yelling out to his Wildcats. Score 20-18, Kentucky by two. Bertelkamp has 4 points. Verderber on a give and go from Macy. The basket is good. The call against Verderber.
excellent backdoor pass by Macy. Oderber called for the charge after the shot. The basket is good.
Timeout here in Birmingham, Alabama. 11:34 left to play in the first half. Kentucky 22, Tennessee 18.
Front of the Tennessee bench, Howard Wood has just been replaced. Coach DeVoe told me that he has been suffering from a bronchial problem and is having trouble breathing and is also a little ill, maybe.
Thank you, John. And into the game is number 31, Chuck Threets, the junior from Lackawanna, New York, to take over. Kentucky is 10 out of 16 from the floor. Tennessee 9 of 14. Kentucky leading by 4, 22 to 18.
That last foul on Verderber was his second. Kentucky doesn't have a lot of depth up front, so they have to be careful with their big man.
Crosby putting it up. Ball out of bounds. Belongs to Tennessee. Out to Bertelkamp. Jump shot from the left side by Carter. Rebounded by Threets. Threets scores. He just came in, as we told you, gets his first field goal there.
He didn't wait very long to get into the action. Good offensive rebound, good follow-up.
22 to 20. Kentucky by two. Foul as Bertelkamp and Plater made contact. That is the seventh team foul against Tennessee with 10:57 left to play in this first half.
Definitely a factor in this first half. And that time, Plater was trying to post up down low. Bertelkamp kind of nudged him out of bounds. The official was alert and saw the foul.
Darden coming into the ball game to replace Bertelkamp for Tennessee. Johnny Darden, number 24. The 1-1 will be in effect. I thought it was going to be Clater to shoot it. It will be. Apparently, Clater had not realized that was the 17th foul. Now Scheidler is into the lineup for the Wildcats to replace Kyle Macy. Jay Scheidler, number 25, a junior from Lawrenceville, Illinois. And here is Clater. 11 points now for Truman.
Kyle Macy is 0 for 2 for the floor. Nothing to get riled up about for the Kentucky fans, but he is having to work a little bit harder tonight because of the defense of Terry Crosby, and I think Coach Joe Hall wants to give him a rest.
Raiders two free throws, make it 24-20, Kentucky. Bank shot up and out of there, and finally taken by Kentucky. That was Reggie Johnson who had the tough go there on the in-and-out shot. Here is Scheidler back for the Wildcats off the TC. Truman Plater. Now into Plater. Plater, that high arching shot. Comes off. Carter with the rebound. Carter takes the jumper. Yes!
Excellent fast break. He pulled up at the just outside the free throw line. Didn't see anybody open under the basket. Laid it up soft and in.
8 points for Carter. Truman Plater off the Cowan. A foul charge to Crosby. That's two on Crosby. We're at the midway point of this first half.
Crosby is an excellent defensive player, Jay, and one of the things the Kentucky team is trying to do is rub him off. Pick him good and solid and try and free the man that he's guarding, whether it be Macy or Plater. That time they did a good job of it. He was called for the foul.
Cowan now has 9 points. A sophomore out of Union County High School in Sturgis, Kentucky. A quick forward. Very strong young man.
Kentucky playing without a legitimate center. He's sometimes a center, sometimes a forward, because they're shuffling forwards into the center position.
Kentucky's lead is 4, 26-22. Johnny Darden getting it across to Carter. Carter comes up short, shot and a rebounding. 3-on-3 break. Scheidler stops, pumps from 20. Comes up short. Foul, Cowan, Kentucky. His first.
That was a good shot by Scheidler. That's his shot. He saw the opportunity, took it. He's just in the game, just a little bit short. On the foul, Cowan going aggressively to the offensive board was caught reaching over the back. Good call by the official. He did get the wrist.
You saw number 35, Clarence Tillman, out of Philadelphia, the freshman into the game for Kentucky. He's working with Bedurber, Williams, Scheidler, and Plater. 9.5 minutes to play, first half. In heavy traffic, get underneath, Reggie Johnson. Does the basket count or not? Let's see if the basket is good. It is. 4 points for Reggie, and the foul called also, a chance for the three-point play. Foul charge to Clater.
The official looked at the other official to see if the basket went in. Excellent move by Johnson. He was trapped with three men around him, but Clater got him on the wrist as he went up.
Reggie Johnson, leading scorer, leading field goal shooter, leading rebounder. Cedar Grove High School, Ellenwood, Georgia. Tillman rebounding out to Scheidler. Kentucky up by two, 26-24. Tillman giving it off to Clater. Clater from 20. Kentucky not shooting as well from the outside with Clater and Macy here in the early going. Underneath. That was Reggie Johnson. The basket is good. The foul is called on Johnson. It is his third. You see Nash getting up. Here comes Nash very quickly. Don DeVoe doesn't want to take any chances with his big guy.
An important basket for Tennessee, but also a very important foul. Johnson goes out with three fouls.
Nash has had an ankle injury coming back off of it. Kevin Nash, 43, a hustler. Trenton, Michigan, 6'10", sophomore. Clater on the free throw line, 1-1. Score tied at 26.
Kentucky doing a great job at the free throw line. Very important now. Tennessee with over seven fouls. Kentucky will be shooting each time.
Kentucky came in here hitting 63 out of 89 in the three tournament games. Kentucky back on top by two. Johnny Darden. Carter back to Darden.
Kentucky still in the 1-3-1 zone.
Shot was put up by Threets, and he missed a tough layup there. Here is Clater. Clater is fouled. Kyle Macy will be coming back into this ball game in a moment. I think he's going to replace Clater, though.
That was a good break for Kentucky on that play. Clater was a little bit out of control. Tennessee had done a good job trapping him, but Threets came along from behind and ran him over. Good call by the official. Good break for the Kentucky team.
Joe Hall talking things over with the freshman Chuck Bedurber. Hall, 50 years old. This might be the finest coaching job of his career. His club has really come on. Kentucky is 8 out of 8 from the free throw line. 9 out of 9. Has 16 points here in the first half. He comes out of the lineup, and Kyle Macy comes back in.
Very important notice there, Jay, that what the free throw can do. Clater had missed his last five shots, but he's got four straight points at the free throw line, and he's kept Kentucky alive.
Johnny Darden. Darden to Carter, back to Darden. Back to Carter for the jumper. He got it. Gary Carter. Terry Crosby, excuse me, I said Carter. 6 points for Crosby. 30-28, Kentucky. Scheidler hits it. His first field goal.
Scheidler is the freshest of the Kentucky guards, playing not quite as many minutes as Macy or Plater. It'd be key for this game if he could get the hot hand.
Darden out front, back to Terry Crosby, back to Darden. Trying to penetrate that zone. This is Carter. Darden now going up the middle with one. Rebound battle for, saved by Nash. Off underneath, put up. Chuck Threets has 4 points. 32-30, Kentucky by two. 7.5 minutes to go in this first half. Macy back to Bedurber for the jumper. Bedurber can do it inside or outside. That's his first field goal. Poised freshman he is.
That time Tennessee tried to double team Macy. When they did, they got in trouble. He hit the open man.
Nash with an excellent move there. Nash has his first field goal. 34-32 Kentucky, and they're going here. Seen a lot of offense in this first half. Scheidler. That's Tillman. Shot blocked by Nash. Picked up by Scheidler. Off to Bederber. Up and in. Basket counts. Bederber on the charge. Back into the lineup, Fred Cowan for Kentucky. And Bederber's going to have to sit it out. He has three.
All three of them offensive fouls, I think. Two of them he scored, one he didn't, but driving to the basket.
6 minutes, 54 seconds left to play here in the first half. Here's some first-round scores as we started here on Wednesday. Alabama over Florida and Kentucky beating Mississippi. Georgia got by Mississippi State. Auburn over Vanderbilt. Then we moved into the second round. Kentucky and Alabama played a tremendous game, won by the Wildcats by one. Auburn over Georgia. And last night, it was Tennessee over Auburn and Kentucky over LSU. LSU had been the number one seed in this tournament, the regular season conference champion. Kentucky 36, Tennessee 32. Jumper put up by Terry Crosby. Rebound taken by Kyle Macy. Macy back to the attack for the Wildcats.
Kentucky still with a three-forward offense, bringing Tillman in for Bederber. Electing right now to go with the two-guard offense.
Shot by Cowan. Rebounded by Nash. He takes up a lot of room in there. Here's Darden. Johnny Darden. Underneath. The shot goes up by Greets. He is fouled. Foul is on Cowan. His second. And Greets is going to go to the line.
Excellent inside pass by Johnny Darden. Penetrating into that free throw lane area and passing the ball inside. He's done a good job tonight, and he did an excellent job last night.
Number 20 for Kentucky, 6'2", a senior, co-captain, Morganfield, Kentucky, into the lineup. LaVon Williams coming out, so it is Tillman, Cowan, Scheidler, Macy, and Casey. Greets hits the free throw. He took over for Nash and has been playing very well. Now Nash and Greets are both in there. Rebound Tillman out to Scheidler. 6 minutes to play in the first half. 36-33, Kentucky. Tillman guarded by Nash. A lot of contact there. Tillman getting it back. Tillman hits it.
Excellent outside shot by the freshman. He's a great outside shooter. He's played very well for Kentucky in this tournament.
That's the first points for Tillman. 38-33, 5-point lead. They tried to get it in underneath the Greets. Taken away. Here comes Kentucky. Macy with a fake and got it. That's his first field goal and the first points of the game for Macy.
Classic Kyle Macy move. Under control, fakes the man off his feet, goes up for an unbalanced jump shot.
The Big Blue are up by seven. For Kentucky. Cowan coming out. It is Cowan out of the lineup. Tillman, Scheidler, Casey, Prater, and Macy going for Kentucky. Joe Hall's really upset about something. Hall going to the scores table below. Seventh year at Kentucky, 154 victories, 52 defeats.
Should be shooting instead of Carter, one of their better free throw shooters.
Carter gets 2 points. He has 10 in the game. 40-35 Kentucky. 5 minutes to play in this first half. And Coach Hall is being told to sit down. He's about to draw himself. a technical.
Kentucky now with four guards in there and a freshman, Clarence Tillman. Look for them to use their speed and quickness and nurse their lead a little bit, hold on to the ball, stay in control of the game.
It'll be on Darden.
Macy showed that he still has some quickness in his legs after four games. He got to that corner, saw that hole down the middle, and boy, did he explode to that basket and draw the foul.
Kyle Macy, an All-American. That last foul was charged to Darden. 3 points for Macy, and Kentucky really getting the job done at the stripe.
And this is their best free throw shooter on the year. The Southeastern Conference number one free throw shooter, better than 86% for the season.
One of the best in the nation, considering the amount of play. 42-37, Kentucky. Nash for the Volunteers. Out to Darden. Terry Crosby. Crosby and Carter working it against the zone. 4:10 to go in this first half. The Kentucky fans yelling defense. Nash underneath. Coupling for it. Jump ball. Tillman. And Gary Carter will jump.
That time we could see how mismatched Kentucky is inside. Dwayne Casey, 6'4". Kevin Nash, 6'10", guarding each other in the zone defense.
Howard Wood will come back into the lineup, number 44 for Kentucky, or for Tennessee. And going out is... Tillman controlling the tap, and Casey let it go. Casey made a mistake and let that ball go. Coming up at halftime, we have a very interesting visual feature put together by our technical crew. The dunk is definitely back in college basketball, and you'll see that at halftime. This is Jay Randolph with Jeff Mullins here at the Civic Center in Birmingham, Alabama. The first annual renewal of the Southeastern Conference Tournament in 27 years. Kentucky and Tennessee vying for the title and the NCAA berth here.
And what a tournament it's been, Jay. LaVon Williams now in for Kentucky. They've got two forwards in, three guards.
Carter to put it in play, gets it out to Crosby, and now Johnny Darden. Carter back out to Darden. Carter from 20. Nice shooting by Carter. He has a dozen. 42-37, Kentucky. Jay Scheidler on the move. Casey. 3.5 minutes to play.
Again, with three guards in there, Kentucky going to their semi-delay game. But look for them, if they get the good shot, they'll take it. But at the same time, they'd like to use as much clock as they can, keep their players as rested as they can.
We're coming down to 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Left in this first half. Kentucky is led by as many as 8. They lead now by 5. Inside the 3-minute mark. Kentucky winning here last night, 80-67. Tennessee with a 75-64 win over Auburn last night. The big blue and the big orange playing for the title.
Kentucky runs this play from a stack. Four men in the free throw lane area, the two guards down low, and the guards will interchange, take turns handling the ball.
.225 to go. Scheidler out to Macy.
Macy calling out a play, number 5.
Kentucky, on neutral floors this season, is undefeated. They're 4-0. Tillman underneath with a turnaround jumper. Rebound, Clayton. Boy, he did a good job.
What a strong rebound for the guard. He was up high by the rim, brought it down. strong.
18 points for Clater. A very big first half for TC. Ball goes out of bounds, a turnover. That is only the fourth turnover for Tennessee. Kentucky with only one here in the first half.
Very conservatively well-coached game so far. Neither team turning the ball over. Tennessee, however, with Kentucky in this freeze, doesn't want to turn the ball over. They need shots now before the half.
44-37 Kentucky. A minute 25 to play. Scheidler controlling the basketball for the Wildcats.
I was just going to mention, that's one thing Kentucky has to watch. Five second holding the ball. That time Scheidler got called for the jump ball.
Had a shot at Joe Hall there. He tried to recruit you when he was at Regis College in Denver, didn't he?
Yes, I remember him very well. A great fella, a very persistent recruiter, and a fine coach.
Second turnover in the game for Kentucky. Johnny Darden getting it around to Crosby. Darden with it. A minute and 10 to play. Carter batted away out of bounds with 1 minute left in this first half.
Kentucky doing something very well in this 1-3-1 zone, using their hands. All the players have their hands up, waving their arms, trying to get hands in the passing lane.
Nash trying to get it into Wood. He does. He missed the layup. And here comes Clater with 45 seconds left. That was a tough miss there. That was a big miss. Now if Kentucky can hold on or get two more, they'll go to the dressing room at halftime in excellent shape. Scheidler with 25 seconds to play. Foul on Scheidler. Offensive foul.
Scheidler has the toughest matchup in this little delay offense because he's got the small guard Darden guarding him. Darden has a quickness advantage. That time he anticipated well, was able to draw the charge.
Now the Volunteers have time to score, and they could get back within five. 20 seconds to go.
Kentucky going to a man-to-man these last 16 seconds.
Darden getting it over to Crosby. Back out to Darden. Looks up at the clock. 10 seconds. Eight. Missing, tapped up by Wood, no good. A foul called at the buzzer. A foul called at the buzzer. Or was it after the buzzer?
It looked like the official called a foul, but he's saying no foul now.
It was after the buzzer. So we come to halftime here at the Civic Center in Birmingham. It is Kentucky 44, Tennessee 37.
This moment in sports is brought to you by Nike. We'll be right back.
Well, I think you can see right there why fatigue is taking its toll here.
It certainly is, and something that Kentucky has considered for two nights. The Kentucky team staying to the zone as much as they can. They feel like that rests their players a little bit more, and on the offensive end, trying to use as much clock. The last two nights, they felt like they've had to control the clock. Tennessee, in talking to Coach Don DeVoe before the game, felt like there are two critical areas for them. They had to control the boards. They're bigger. They had to do the job on the boards. Thus far, I think it's a toss-up. And also, they felt like defensively, they had to keep the pressure on Kentucky, had to keep making Kentucky work hard, hoping to tire them out even more.
Kentucky leading here at halftime. They've shot better than 64% here in the first half. And we'll be back with more after these messages from your local stations.
Well, everybody on the bench, we all psyched up and motivated. And my part is try to keep everybody happy and things. Try to keep spirit on the bench.
I know you miss being in there. Good luck. Nice to see you.
Okay, thanks.
That's Dwight Anderson. Here's Jay Randolph.
Thank you, John Ferguson, very much. Dwight Anderson, maybe the fastest guard ever to play at Kentucky. Jeff, statistics on this first half.
Kentucky continues to blister the basket. Again, 64% the first half, hitting over 60% for the whole tournament. 12 for 12 from the free throw line. Tennessee shooting pretty well, mainly Carter and Crosby from the outside against the zone. Rebounds equal, turnovers almost equal, 4-3. Kentucky has three turnovers.
And we're ready to go to the final scheduled 20 minutes of play. Kentucky 44, Tennessee 37. Cowan for Kentucky going up against Reggie Johnson. And it is Tennessee who go left to right here controlling in this start of the second half. Darden starts the second half along with Carter, Johnson, that's Threets, and this is Crosby. Crosby gets it right back out to Darden.
Yes, and a big foul because he's the guy that's dogging Kyle Macy. He may have to let up a little bit the defensive pressure. Both teams with two players with three fouls each now.
Kentucky starting the second half with Macy, Cowan, Vederber, Williams, and Plater. Kyle Macy. Later. Kentucky with the lead, being very patient. Macy, nice fake, double pump. Tapped up in underneath there. Cowan couldn't get it in, and here comes Tennessee's Darden. Kentucky's zone. Carter, out to Darden.
Kentucky staying with their 1-3-1 zone.
Put up by Carter, battle for jump ball. They'll unravel it. I'm not sure who's going to jump. There's so many up and down there on the floor. We'll wait and see.
I believe they're going to call it with Cowan and Carter. Cowan was the first one on the floor trying to get it. Carter came over his back and tied him up.
Jeff, we should mention that LSU, a fine basketball team, winning the regular season, may have an opportunity for NCAA play, and a large bid might be coming their way tomorrow afternoon. That's sheer speculation on our part.
Yes, they had an excellent regular season and, of course, winning the SEC regular season championship, so they are definitely a candidate. They were fifth-ranked in the country.
The tap is controlled by Kentucky. LeVon Williams up to Plater. Kentucky has played exceptional basketball since Big Chuck Alexinas opted to give it up. Here's Plater. Rebounded by Threets. Johnny Darden. Crosby out to Darden. Get it in under, and it is put up there by Reggie Johnson.
Tennessee working very hard to get the ball into Reggie Johnson. That time, LeVon Williams called for the foul.
It's his first. Reggie Johnson will go to the line. Fourth all-time scorer in Tennessee history. Tennessee averaging 78 points a game coming in here and shooting 70.5 as a team.
We might mention it last night. Both teams came out of the locker room ready to play. Tonight, they're both having a tough time getting started.
8 points for Reggie. 44-39, Kentucky by five. Macy bringing it down against Crosby. Off to Minerva, back to Macy. Macy from 25. Tapped up underneath by Minerva. Taken away. Long pass. Foul on Macy against Reggie Johnson.
That time, Tennessee alert, getting the ball all the way down court to Johnson. Johnson going in for a layup. Macy doing the only thing that he could. Reaching in, trying to knock the ball out of his hand and hitting him on the wrist.
That's the second foul against Macy and team foul number two against Kentucky. Reggie Johnson, a junior at 6'9", 76% free throw shooter. At 36 this year is his high against Georgia. He has 10 points. It's 44-41. Kentucky's lead cut to three and Tennessee presses.
Tennessee in a man-to-man press after the made free throw. Kentucky taking their time getting the ball inbound.
Kyle Macy getting it over to Cowan and back to Macy. That's Clater. Kentucky a bit cold with their shooting. Here comes Crosby for Tennessee. The Volunteers can get back within one with a bucket here.
Kentucky has had good shots. They just haven't been able to connect.
Shot put up in the lane by Johnson. No good. A foul call. It's on LeVon Williams, his second.
Strong inside move by Johnson. He put up a strong shot. Came out long on the rebound. He was there to get it back. LeVon Williams fighting for the ball. Called for the foul.
It has been Reggie Johnson, who has really been tough in the clutch, in close for Tennessee. Darden getting it around to Carter. Carter's basket is good. Offensive foul on Carter. The basket counts. 14 points for Carter.
That was an out-of-bounds play, similar to the one Kentucky runs. Double pick on the weak side for Carter. He took one step to the baseline, up strong. Good defensive position by the Kentucky player.
There's Don DeVoe, 38-year-old native of Sabina, Ohio, played at Ohio State. The Kentucky lead is cut to one. Macy gets it out to Minerva. Off to Clater. Back to Minerva. He loses it. And going and scoring and getting the lead for Tennessee. Crosby.
Kentucky has been outscored 8-0 at the start of this second half. Tennessee upping the defensive pressure.
Kentucky has been stuck on 44, and here's a turnover, the fourth in the game. And the Wildcats, for the first time in this tournament, a little disorganized.
Yes, they are. That time, Clater tried to bring the ball up the floor all by himself.
16:43 remaining to be played. Tennessee back in business. 45-44, they lead it.
Well, we won tonight, man. It was quite a fight. Now it's all behind. Got blue ribbon on my mind.
I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind.
There are a lot of beers, but there's only one Pabst. It's brewed to be the best, naturally, with no artificial ingredients, and you can taste it.
I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind.
Magnavox is handing out money during the big Magnavox annual sale. Come in now for a great deal on these Magnavox touch-tune color TVs and get a rebate right on the spot. Save on Decorator stereos, save on Magnavox component systems, and get a rebate right on the spot. And save even more on remote control special bonus offer. The most exciting Magnavox annual sale ever, because Magnavox is handing out money.
At the conclusion of tonight's game, five players to be selected for the Southeastern Conference All-Tournament team. And Nike Shoes, one of our network sponsors, will contribute $1,000 in each player's name to the general scholarship fund at his university. Tennessee, up by one, has come back strong. We have played 3.5 minutes of the second half, and Kentucky has not scored.
And Coach Don DeVoe of Tennessee wants his team to try and bring Kentucky out of the man-to-man, out of the zone defense. They want to play against a man-to-man. First time they've had the lead, first time they've been able to do that.
Joe Hall motioning to his troops where he wants them to come out.
Joe staying in his zone, but moving his zone out a little bit farther, just trying to trap a little bit.
Tennessee leading 45-44.
Actually, Kentucky had a string run against them, and fatigue might have been a factor, Jay. This stretch in here might give them a little bit of a blow, but Tennessee prefers to play against their man-to-man defense.
Yeah, you wonder about the strategy. Kentucky can get a breather here.
Kentucky has to be careful. Reggie Johnson wandering around that basket behind the Kentucky defense. Got to be alert for that high lob pass.
There's Don DeVoe, who was 5 years at Virginia Tech, 2 years at Wyoming, first-year coach. Done a great job with the Volunteers, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. He's earned the respect of his fellow coaches in just 1 year in this Southeastern Conference.
15 minutes to play in the game. The Southeastern Conference NCAA bid on the line in this renewal of the Southeastern Conference tournament.
Is 1-for-6 from the field, and Clater has hit one of his last 8 shots. Big question, could it be fatigue?
Well, it's got to be fatigue, no question about that. The question is, can the Wildcats gather themselves? They've been held scoreless here in the second half, and we have played nearly 6 minutes.
Coach Don DeVoe, Tennessee, has finally decided to attack the zone. I think he realized that they had some momentum going. Kentucky was getting to rest playing defense. They're going to attack it a little bit more.
This is Johnny Darden. He's the point guard looking in at the zone. Crosby back out to Darden. 14 minutes to play. Go down courtside to John Ferguson.
Men, we're talking about the fatigue aspect as far as Kentucky's concerned. Think about that a while ago. He said that Kentucky is really tired but playing hard.
The turnover there gives the ball to Kentucky, and they have a chance to retake the lead and get their first points.
Tennessee had tried that high lob pass, as we had talked about. Kentucky alert and stolen.
Bert Bertelkamp going to come back into the lineup for Tennessee. Bertelkamp to replace Johnny Darden. There's Bertelkamp, number 10, a junior from Knoxville out of Bearden High School, a point guard, a very heady player. Kentucky still looking for its first points of the second half.
Tennessee still keeping the defensive pressure on, doing a little bit more double teaming, trying to wear down the Kentucky team.
Out to Viderber. Truman Clater. Clater banking it up. Well, it went nearly 7 minutes without a bucket. 20 points for Truman Clater. Kentucky back on top by one, 46-45.
I wouldn't be surprised to see this Kentucky team a little bit fresher now. They've been able to relax a little bit on defense due to the stalling offense of Tennessee.
Foul is on Clater. His second.
Kentucky has been fortunate. Their fouls in the second half, they've committed 5, but not against their key men who are in foul trouble, Cowan and Verderber.
Two team fouls. goals against Tennessee, five against Kentucky. Mertelkamp from the corner, Carter. Capped up and in. It looked like Reggie Johnson. No, it was Threets. Threets tapped it in. 47 to 46, Tennessee. 12 and a half minutes to play. Kyle Macy. Out to Clayton.
Running their offense.
There's Macy. That's got to help him.
That time, Kentucky set a pick for Macy. He was able to get Crosby off a few feet. That's his shot. That's what he needs to do.
Macy with 6 points. Prater with a steal. Prater drives. Lost the ball. Long pass down to Crosby. Crosby hits it. That's a four-point play. As the SEC tournament continues.
Wendy's, we make them as juicy as we can. If they trickle down your chin a little, we're sorry.
Located in Evansville, Owensboro, Henderson, and Madisonville.
The new American road car has arrived at Debbelwolf Ford. It's the new 1979 LTD. At Debbelwolf Ford, we can offer a 79 LTD two-door sedan with radio, air, vinyl roof. The list price is $73.24. Debbelwolf's special price, $59.95. The 79 LTD has more to offer. More seat room, more window area, more driver's convenience. At Debbelwolf Ford, we'll give you better service, plus a good savings.
Don DeVoe was an assistant to Bobby Knight up at Army. And he's talking to his club. Remember, you can relive the exciting 79 Southeastern Conference tournament for many years, obtaining your own copy of the official SEC program. It outlines the tournament history, scoring records, 96 pages of colorful basketball information. Write to Post Office Box 1979, Lexington, Kentucky, the zip code 40593. It's $3. There is Dwight Anderson looking on. Tennessee leads 49 to 48. Macy getting it into Vederber. LaVon Williams, Truman Clater, and Fred Cowan out there for the Wildcats. Mertelkamp, Crosby, Johnson, Carter, and Threets in the lineup for Tennessee. We're nearing the midway point of the second half. Cowan. Cowan from 15. Oh, nice shooting by Fred Cowan.
The guard around play that Kentucky loves to run. That time it was Cowens coming off the screen, shooting the 16-footer.
Cowan has 12 points, 50 to 49. Kentucky, the lead now shifting back and forth. Reggie Johnson put it up. It belongs to Tennessee.
Tennessee has been very active on their offensive boards this second half. Kentucky's going to have to block out a little bit better. And get some more help in there. Get their guards in there to help on the rebound.
Mertelkamp. Getting it around to Carter. Back to Mertelkamp and back to Carter. Kentucky in the zone. Carter in underneath. Nice play. Bringing it up. Threets. Threets has 9 points. That's the way to attack that zone. Tennessee playing very well right now. Here's a pass to Clayton.
Step went straight up. He was fouled, and he's got a chance for a three-point play, and he has redeemed himself.
a foul charge to Bertelkamp. Johnny Darden is going to come back in for Tennessee. Camp coming out. Truman Plater can put Kentucky up by two. He does. And the Wildcats have really been hot at the free throw line.
They've been shooting well at the line the whole tournament. That's why they led the regular season conference as the best free throw shooter in the conference as a team.
Crosby. Oh, yes. Crosby cuts the cords. A dozen for Crosby. The game is tied for the first time all night at 53. Violation on Cowan. Stepped on the line over here. Five turnovers for Kentucky. Tennessee has committed five.
Last night it was Crosby that was the zone breaker the first half, and he's getting his confidence from the outside. Kentucky should be careful.
Tennessee with a chance to break the tie. Crosby. Rebounded by Viderber, the freshman. Gets it out to Truman Plater. 9.5 minutes to play. Score tied at 53. Is no good. No basket. Foul charge to Kentucky.
Excellent defensive
Cowan
by Darden. Cowan's dribbling the ball over towards Plater. Continued to move and overran Darden for his fourth foul and a very big one.
Brett Cowan with four personals. Kentucky 16 fouls. Tennessee with three. Tillman will come back in, number 35 for the Wildcats. The freshman, fine shooter out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania's West High School. Listen to those Kentucky fans trying to rally their butts. Oh, big move.
Kentucky now in a 2-3 zone for the first time.
Johnny Darden, banking it off the glass. Darden hits it, and a foul on Darden. The basket will count. Second foul on Darden. Boy, we've had a lot of charging calls in this ballgame.
We certainly have, and we've had great concentration by the offensive player. We've had quite a few charging fouls, but the basket's good on the continuation.
Joe Hall, very upset with that official. Tennessee by two. Kentucky trying to get the tie at 55 with 8:45 to play. Whistle and a foul. Kyle Macy charged with an offensive foul. It's his third.
After he gave the ball up, Kyle Macy, cutting through the middle, was called for the offensive foul, and he doesn't like it.
Tennessee will have the basketball. Tennessee's biggest lead has been two. Kentucky's biggest lead has been eight. Crosby and Darden working with it. There's Crosby's shot blocked by Tillman and taken away. Oh, that's a fine play by Tillman.
Great play by the freshman from Kentucky.
Viderber out to Macy. On the foul.
Good play by the Kentucky offense. They haven't been shooting too well from the outside. That time they got it into their big man Williams. He was able to draw the foul.
Pavon Williams, an 80% free throw shooter. Third point of the game for LeBron. Boy, he was highly recruited out of Denver.
Get up, Chuck.
Missing. 55, 54. Tennessee on the odd number, up by one.
Make a play of it.
8 minutes. 20 seconds to play.
A little strategy by both coaches here.
We're going to have a timeout with 7:16 remaining in regulation time. The winner gets the NCAA bid. They might speculate on that Nike All-Tournament team, Jeff. $1,000 going to the scholarship fund. Macy, Clater, Johnson, Crosby, King. You got some names you think
well,
of?
Well, I think Bobby Kadich and Bubba Price played very well for their Auburn team throughout the tournament.
Jay Scheidler into the Kentucky lineup. Scheidler, Tillman, Williams, Macy, and Viderber going for the Wildcats.
It's going to be interesting to see if the strategy continues. Tennessee would like Kentucky to come out of that zone. Kentucky wants to stay in it. What will the coaches do?
7:15 to play. Tennessee by one at 55-54.
Kentucky in a 2-3 zone matchup. It's kind of disguised as a man-to-man because they match up man-to-man, but as soon as the ball shifts, they sag off into the matchup zone.
Jeff, you know we have two great traditional rivals playing here, Tennessee and Kentucky. And Kentucky has dominated the SEC tournaments over the years, and Tennessee is second in domination.
They've had some great clashes over the years, and it is indeed one of the finest rivalries in the Southeast.
Tennessee 36-15 in Southeast Conference tournament play. Kentucky 60-6. 6 minutes and 25 seconds to play.
Tennessee very patient on offense.
Don DeVoe apparently didn't want to get into a running match with Kentucky with the game this close. So he's sitting on a one-point lead for the most part right here. As we come to 6 minutes left to play in this game. That's the Kentucky crowd.
Kentucky.
They're really rooting them.
And Joe Hall signaling his team to do a little bit more double teaming, try and double team the ball whenever they can out front.
Joe Hall, took the coaching job at St. Louis University for a couple of days and then decided to go back to Kentucky and wait for Adolph Rupp to say goodbye. And he's taken over for the legend and done a remarkable job.
Joe Hall spending a lot of this half on his feet, directing his team, telling his team now to come out defensively, waving him out a little bit more, but staying in the matchup zone.
5 minutes to play. I've got to believe, Jeff, that this tactic by Tennessee may be keeping the Volunteers in the ballgame, but it also has got to be helping Kentucky from the standpoint of the freshness to the players out there.
I'd say freshness and also perhaps foul trouble. They're not going to pick up that fourth and fifth foul on the Kentucky players in this kind of defense. However, we've seen strategy go both ways in basketball. That's the exciting thing about it.
They've had a lot of records broken here. Four overtimes the other night in that Georgia-Auburn game. 101 points scored by Kentucky, a new tournament record. 201 points in a game, a new tournament record. You see the time remaining.
Kyle Macy with 31 field goals in three games broke Cliff Hagin's record of 30 in four games.
Kentucky has committed 17 fouls. Tennessee. Assistants, Bob Burton, Tom Deaton, and Bobby Stevens. Dick Parsons, Leonard Hamilton, and Joe Dean assisting Joe Hall. 3 minutes and 30 to go.
That's the trap that Joe Hall has been talking about. He wanted his players to tie up their guards out high. That time they did it, they stole the ball.
And the foul charge to Carter. take a timeout, and we'll be back with more as the Southeastern Conference Tournament continues.
I noticed here on the floor during that last long possession by Tennessee that Tennessee is very cool, very calm, very collected. Kentucky, on the other hand, is patient and also a little jaded, a little physically tired, I think. And back to the play.
All right, John, certainly these two clubs with pride and poise going to the wire here.
I don't think, Jay, that Kentucky can afford to hold on to the ball. The Tennessee team is a little fresher, and I look for them to keep the pressure on them defensively. It'd be awful tough for Kentucky to freeze the clock down, but they will go only for one shot.
Six team fouls now against Tennessee, so the 1-1 going into effect on the next Tennessee free throw.
I meant to say they'll go only for the good shot. They want a good shot now.
Cowan is out there playing with four fouls for Kentucky, along with Bederber, Scheidler, Macy, and LaVon Williams. Bederber. And a whistle and a foul. Let's see who it is. Bederber is fouled by Darden.
Great recovery by Bederber. He threw, Kentucky was trying to get the ball inside. His pass was deflected, but he went after it. Darden hit him on the wrist.
Big free throw coming here for the freshman. A 1-1 in effect for both teams. Bederber.
Amazing how the Kentucky players, Macy, Scheidler, Bederber, all shoot their free throws a great deal alike.
Score is tied at 55. Second time we've been tied. Kentucky is 15 out of 17 at the line. 55 all with 2:50 to play. Going right to the wire in this one. The winner moves on to the NCAA tournament.
Same strategy by both teams. Kentucky in a matchup, Tennessee holding the ball. Joe Hall on his feet. I still think he would like to trap whenever possible out front.
2.5 to play. Getting it over there to Crosby back out front. Underneath. Traveling call.
Oh, what a big play for Kentucky. Darden made a great penetration effort. Pass to Johnson. It was a little low for the big guy. At his feet, he was called for shuffling his feet.
The turnover is the sixth against Tennessee. 2 minutes and 12 seconds left to play. Clater is coming back into the lineup to replace Bederber.
Kentucky with a three-guard offense now. We may see them stall the ball out or use up some of this clock. If they can hold the ball, they'll be in control.
We've had some really remarkable games in this tournament, and this is no exception. Scheidler doing a good job getting it back to Macy. Timeout, Kentucky. Remaining in regulation time, 55 all. We'll be back with more after this word from your local station as the SEC tournament continues. Macy to put it in play. Gets it to Cowan. Cowan to LaVon Williams. Inside of 2 minutes now. Truman Clater. Crosby, Carter, Threets, and Johnson in the lineup for Tennessee. This is Scheidler for Kentucky. Off to Macy. 1:40 to go.
This is their stall offense where they want to use up the clock. Again, Scheidler has Darden on him. Once before, he did charge in this situation, so he'll have to be very careful. Darden has a quickness advantage.
Scheidler with the ball. Coming to 1:20 left to play. Second in two nights. 55 all. 1 minute to play.
play
in this offense. Kentucky likes their guards to handle it, but they bring their big men out as a release, as they did that time with Cowan.
50 seconds. Cowan off the Scheidler. Kentucky trying to hold on and get the last shot.
The fans will notice at home as the guards dribble, the referees are counting it, looking for the five-second tie-up. Kentucky has to be careful to avoid that.
And all around us, they're coming to their feet. 15 seconds to go. Timeout, Kentucky. Kentucky, the Wildcats have the basketball. They're going to try to win it with a final shot. If they do win it, it will be their 14th Southeastern Conference tournament title. Tennessee won it 36, 41, and 43. They've been in the finals. This marks the eighth time for them.
And Jay, here in the Birmingham Civic Center, I believe we're having some trouble with the clock. The coach is talking to the scorer. 2 seconds went off the clock. It happened once before in the game, and they had to adjust it.
You know, there was 15 seconds on the clock when I saw them start to call a timeout, and now we end up with 10. Now they put it back to 12. Don DeVoe right there was a starter at Ohio State after being a substitute on that great 62 team with Havlicek and Lucas. John Ferguson has a note courtside.
Jay, I think the problem with the clock is that after timeout was called on the sidelines off to the timer's left, that the clock was allowed to run maybe 2 seconds, and it went off a little late, and I think that that's what the officials came in to tell the timer about, and so the correction of the clock has now been made.
Well, we have an even dozen up there.
Let's talk about the strategy for a moment. Coach Don DeVoe, I think he'll put pressure on the outlet pass, but he's telling his players, don't foul. Kentucky, a tough team to guard in the closing moments. Three great outside shooters, Schuyler, Macy, Clater. Good inside men with Cowens and Williams.
It will be Scheidler's responsibility to put the ball in play. Now they've decided it will be Cowan. And now Don DeVoe wants a timeout. He wanted to take a look at what they were doing, and now he wants to talk it over with his folks. Tennessee coming in here tonight with 19 victories and 11 defeats. The Wildcats, 19 and 10. Kentucky and Tennessee giving us just a superb finish to what has been a dynamite few days of basketball.
And Don DeVoe and his assistants trying to decipher the Kentucky offensive pattern, trying to decide what they were going to do. However, there's no guarantee that Kentucky will come out in the same formation.
Again, down courtside, let's go to John Ferguson.
The Tennessee people are talking about the clock still, and of course they're getting their strategy ready for the tiebreaker here, if that is to be in the last 12 seconds. I can't see all the way down, but the conversation with Joe Hall, who's on his knees among his players, is really intense as you're looking at Don DeVoe, who's getting himself set in the event Kentucky scores, then he wants his team to have a set offense.
Don DeVoe looks like he's anticipating some kind of stack on this side of the floor as Kentucky runs their offense, and he's giving them last second directions. Kentucky doing one thing different right now. Macy has been taking the ball out of bounds most times. He is on the floor. It looks like he may have the ball or do something.
Now Scheidler again has been given the job of getting it in, unless they change their minds again. Here we go, 12 seconds in regulation, into Macy. 10 seconds, Macy puts up the shot, it is short, Macy gets it back, banks it up, no good, tapped up underneath by LeVon Williams, no good, and timeout with 1 second. Let's see, is it over or not? I thought there was 1 second on the clock. The officials are coming to check it out. I don't know if we're through with the regulation or not, we are. The officials say it's all over. So we are going to the first overtime. and actually the second overtime in this tournament. The other night here, a remarkable game. Georgia and Auburn went four overtimes.
Yes, and we saw a lot of the same strategy. The two teams holding the ball for the last shot. That time, Kentucky giving the ball to Macy, their bread and butter player. Crosby on him tight all the way. He faked Crosby up a little bit, jumped in. I believe there was some contact. I think the official thought they both might have initiated and didn't call anything.
The score at halftime was 44-37, Kentucky. We're tied at 55 as we get set for the first overtime period. The officials, Paul Galvin, Don Shea, and Ben Dunn, have worked this ball game, and we end up all even.
I might add that Tennessee did a great job defensively. Not only Crosby, but Cowan got that rebound, Jay, inside. Somebody in there we couldn't see knocked the ball out of his hand. He had a good opportunity.
John Ferguson at courtside just spoke with one of the officials. John, let's go to you.
Don Shea said that both the coaches thought that there would be time left on the clock, but he was the one who made the determination that time had expired, and that's the way it is.
All right, overtime.
Kentucky back to their big lineup. Three forwards, two guards, Clater and Macy.
It is Vedderber, Williams, Cowan, Macy, and Clater going against Tennessee, who has Reggie Johnson jumping and controlling it. And that's Darden. Also in there is Carter. Underneath, Freets was fouled. No basket. No basket. The foul is charged to LeVon Williams. It is his fourth.
Excellent inside pass by Johnson. He got the ball in the main lane, passed it down low.
Cowan with four, Williams with four, Vedderber with three. For Tennessee, Johnson, Crosby each have three. Bertelkamp with four sitting on the bench. Chuck Freets puts Tennessee on top by one over Kentucky, 56-55.
Not a good regular season free throw shooter, only 44%.
Air ball that time. So the lead is one for Tennessee. We're in the first overtime period. If you just happen to walk in the house and turn the set on, along with John Ferguson, Jeff Mullins, this is Shea Randolph here in Birmingham. The Southeastern Conference championship game in overtime. A foul charge.
Tournament, Jay. He should be proud of himself. He battled hard. He was the workhorse for the Kentucky team inside.
And Cowan, just a sophomore, has a great career ahead of him in Lexington with his Wildcats. Jay Scheidler is up. Coach Joe Hall down below, sending Scheidler in.
Kentucky back with their three-guard offense. Bit of a liability on defense. It's a little bit tougher for him. It looks like Kentucky is lined up man-to-man, though, now.
Pass in underneath, and a foul charged on Scheidler. Reggie Johnson scoring. Reggie hit the bucket, and he has a chance for a three-point play that would put Tennessee up by four. 12 points for Reggie Johnson. And they're celebrating on the Tennessee bench. But we still have a long, long way to go here.
A lot of time left in this ball game. That play is exactly the reason Kentucky wanted to stay in the zone and why Tennessee wanted to try and get him out of him. Johnson's tough to handle inside by himself.
Tennessee has its biggest lead in the ball game. Kentucky led by as many as eight early in the first half. 4:41 to play, and the Wildcats are in deep trouble down four. We're in overtime. Kyle Macy. Clayton.
He's going to try and hold the ball or at least look for a good shot. Kentucky in a man-to-man. They need the ball back.
The Wildcats. Boy, they've got to be tired. Four rugged games in four nights and now stretched into overtime against the Volunteers. 59-55 Tennessee in overtime. 3:50 to play. Shot put up by Carter, a foul. It didn't go down for him. He's getting up slowly. He's all right, though.
Good pass inside by Tennessee to Carter. Kentucky gambling, that's what you're vulnerable to. Bederber did a good job, though, saving a layup.
The foul is on Bederber, the pre-dental student, the freshman, his fourth. And now Howard Wood is going to come into the lineup for Tennessee. We haven't seen Wood much in this ball game. Breach will come out. 14 points for Breach. And for Carter, excuse me. Breach has 10 points. Here is Carter. 60-55. Kentucky down by 5. Could be down by 6. Lead in the game for Tennessee. Long pass, Clayton. Clayton drives and missed the net. Kentucky's basketball. Joe Hall is beside himself. That would have been a big bucket, I needn't tell you.
Yes, it was. That was a designed out-of-bounds play. Clayton broke down 3, laid it up a little hard, but he didn't give up. Brought back in bounds, knocked the ball out of bounds. Kentucky ball.
Later to put it in play. A disappointed look on his face. Into Macy. Macy's shot is up. No good. There's a foul. Foul charge to Howard Wood.
Good follow-up by Bederber. Kentucky's got to send their men to the board. Kyle Macy looking a little tired. He's played a lot of minutes, but he's still fighting gamely.
It will be Bederber who goes to the free throw line. Kentucky 15 out of 17 at the stripe in this game.
And they need 2 free throws right now.
Bederber, just a freshman. Oh, what a bright career ahead of this young man.
He certainly has. He's a great fundamental player, and as the Kentucky coach has said, he's a good pressure player. He's been in high school tournaments all his life. He's been there before.
Before it made its decision.
Well, that's what you call good backspin. That spin kept it on the rim, went in the basket.
And cuts it down to 61-57 with 3:40 to play. Tennessee by 4. Crosby out to Dart. The Kentucky fans thought there should have been a charge as Scheidler went down. Lead. Howard Wood stuffs it. 65-59 Tennessee. 2:45 to play. The Tennessee folks rooting it up. Clayton going in. Foul charged on Clayton, the charging foul. And we've had a lot of them in this ballgame.
That time Clayton thought he saw an opening, went in there a little bit out of control.
The Wildcats, who have clawed and scratched their way into this championship game, may see it all slipping away from them here. Reggie Johnson will go to the free throw line. LaVon Williams coming back in for Kentucky.
Howard,
Magic Johnson with 13 points. Tennessee with a 6-point lead. Rebound taken down by Vanderbilt off the shot. 2 minutes, 35 seconds to play.
Coach Joe Hall calling an offensive pattern. It's a double screen for Macy.
Foul charge to Terry Crosby.
Again, the best way for Kentucky to spring Macy, which they were trying to do, is pick on the weak side, getting Crosby off him. That time, Vanderbilt set the pick. Crosby ran over him. He has two free throws.
And that's four on Crosby. Vanderbilt, who made one out of two his last trip, on the 1-1. A big miss. 65-59, Tennessee. 2:25 to go. A foul on Clayton. Camp is back into the game for Tennessee, number 10. We've got Bertelkamp along with Wood, Reggie Johnson, Carter, and Crosby.
Free throws becoming very, very important in the closing minutes of this game.
Carter got it down. 15 points for him. 57-59, 8-point lead Tennessee, their biggest lead in the ballgame. Kentucky led by 8 early. Truman Clayton banks it up and in. Nice shooting by Clayton. Kentucky won't quit.
No, and they need to score quickly. That time Clayton taking advantage of the opening and sticking it in.
2 minutes to play. We're in overtime. Tennessee leading. The Volunteers trying to win their fourth Southeastern Conference title. Scheidler down to Vanderbilt, up and in. And we are back to a 4-point game. 1:48 remaining to be played in overtime. Time out here. Kentucky and Tennessee going at it. We'll be back with more as the Southeastern Conference tournament continues. 67-63. 1:48 to play. Joe B. Hall, the 50-year-old matter at Kentucky. It's young Joe Dean there with him. Dick Parsons and Leonard Hamilton and his staff. Losing Dwight Anderson last night with the broken left wrist. It hurt. Kentucky has never stopped trying, never stopped clawing. Into the ballgame now, Dwayne Casey, number 20, the senior. A minute and 48 to play. Tennessee will put it in play. Now we're in overtime.
With Dwayne Casey in there, Kentucky has a four-guard defense. They want their quickness out there.
And a foul charged against Casey. 1:40 remaining. Final score, Atlantic Coast Conference, North Carolina 71, Duke 63, rah, rah, Carolina. No, you don't like that.
No comment.
No comment. Dwayne Casey coming out, Vanderbilt back in for Kentucky.
Joe Hall using Dwayne Casey to play defense, maybe take a foul when they have to do it because he's a first player.
Carter now with 17 points.
Still plenty of time left in this ball game. A minute 40 to go.
18 points for Carter, 69-63. 6-point lead, Tennessee. Truman Clayton. Rebound, Howard Wood. 1:25 to go. Tennessee.
Yes, they did. Good weak side recovery. Great pass by Reggie Johnson. Vanderbilt trying to get over there, get in the way of the offensive player. Nothing was called. Both players go down.
18 points now for Carter, 71-63. Jeff, that's 8 points, a minute and 16 to play. Tennessee, the Volunteers really in the driver's seat.
Yes, they are. Not only do they have the lead, they've got the clock on their side with only a minute to go.
Carter is up, Viterba is up. This has been a physically tiring experience for both of these clubs, and of course, especially for the Wildcats, who had to play the two extra games here to get to the finals.
Four in a row, Kyle Macy playing 114 minutes up until tonight. Just an example of how many minutes they've played in the last quarter.
Here is Macy. The Wildcats have to hurry. Macy puts it on the way. Great shooter. Timeout with 105 left, 71-65, Tennessee. That was a very big bucket there by Macy. If he doesn't get that one down, they've just about lost all hope.
That's right, and when he gets set like that, that time he was open, he'd use the pick. He's a great shooter.
Jeff, I want to say what a distinct pleasure it has been to work with you, our great crew from TPC, and all the gang here. This has just been a great joy for all of us who've had an opportunity to be here as this tournament has been renewed after 27 years. And I think we're going to see it for a long, long time. It's been something else.
I've got that feeling, Jay. It's been my pleasure to be here, too. And it's really been interesting to see the growth and the interest of the fans. First day, a great deal of interest, but not that real bubbling. Each day it grew. Each day more fans came into the area. And now the final game and a great crowd.
They rolled in here in the rain from Kentucky and Tennessee all day, didn't they?
They were arriving at the hotel all day, and we still have a ball game here with a minute and five to go. Tennessee up by six with the ball. Joe Hall's troops still in the huddle. Tennessee coming out on the floor.
We are in overtime. Tennessee leading 71-65. It was Kentucky 44-37 at half. At the end of regulation time, 55 all. Ready for the inbounds play. The Volunteers leading it. They have the basketball. Long pass to Wood. Can't handle it. Turnover and no time off the clock.
That's right. That was a design play, a stack. But Tennessee doesn't need that now. All they need is the ball. They've got the clock. I'm surprised they tried it. The pass was overthrown. Kentucky ball out under their basket. No time expired.
Truman Clater to put it in. Scheidler to Clater from 20. Ball out of bounds. Tennessee's ball.
That's Clater's shot. He had a good look at the basket from the corner. Again, fatigue. It's tough to shoot when those legs get a little tired, but they're still fighting.
Jump ball. Look out, look out. We've had great sportsmanship on both sides. It wouldn't be marred just because they're shoving and going out there right now.
Great hustle by both players and the officials. Boy, when those guys hit the floor, the two officials were in there calling the jump ball. Kentucky doing a great job trapping that time.
The city of Birmingham and this marvelous Civic Center providing the scene for this renewal of the Southeastern Conference Championship. Jump ball, Macy against Bertelkamp.
Baseline. Crosby getting Kentucky double teaming it. Dwayne Casey reaching in trying to get the ball, called for the foul.
The long walk down to the line to the right.
Kentucky with two chances. Clater's miss and then the jump ball, and they weren't able to convert. And each possession so important now.
Viterba into the lineup for Casey. Joe Hall making that change. Terry Crosby, the senior. He's been tough in the clutch. 1-1. Off the back of the iron. Stolen away. Reggie Johnson had it, lost it. Here comes Macy. Down to Viterba. Up and in. 42 seconds left. It's a 4-point game. Timeout, Kentucky.
Great.
with 41 seconds remaining in overtime. We'll be back with more after this word from your local stations. Mullins, Jay Randolph, Birmingham, Alabama. 41 seconds remaining in the first overtime period. Tennessee leading Kentucky 71-67. Casey has come back into the lineup for Kentucky. I think Kentucky just took its last timeout.
Well, they've used the clock very effectively in the closing minutes here. They still need possession of that ball.
Tennessee trying to get it in. Hurdle camp. Out of bounds on the near side as Scheidler and Carter collided. The ruling was that Carter was out of bounds. Now, Vederber will come back in. You see him, number 34, Don DeVoe, did not like that call.
No, there were a couple calls right there at the end. It looked like Kentucky might have had the tie-up on the original throw-in with 5 seconds. It looked like Tennessee took a long time. Then they got a break on the next call.
Casey putting it down to Plater. Tapped away, out of bounds by Carter. It belongs to Kentucky. 37 seconds left. Tennessee by 4, 71-67.
Joe Hall directing his troops. He can't call a timeout. He'd like to, but he's directing his troops, trying to get them to set up a certain play.
Scheidler out to Clater. Double dribble! Double dribble! What a big turnover that was.
Clater went to his left, started to pick the dribble up, slipped out of his hands. Traveling call.
Casey is back in for Kentucky.
Joe Hall using his timeouts for substitutions, using the change of play for substitutions.
Kentucky will get it. 30 seconds remaining. Scheidler to Macy. Macy from 30. Rebounded by Wood. 20 seconds left. Out it comes to Crosby. Crosby down to Wood. Foul on Macy.
Kentucky's had a number of opportunities due to their hustling defense to get back in it. They just can't get the ball to drop. Tennessee a little careless with the ball in the closing minutes.
Vederber back in to replace Casey. Howard Wood on the line. He has 4 points. Wood is a 76.8% free throw shooter. A 1-1. That'll do it.
That's the big free throw for Tennessee.
Gets them up to the odd point. They lead by 5. And it is 73-67. Tennessee. Later. Banking it up. 73-69. Here's Bertelkamp. He's fouled with 2 seconds left. Tennessee is going to be the Southeast Conference representative in the NCAA. They win their 4th Southeastern Conference tournament. And a great tribute to Don DeVoe and the Volunteers from Knoxville.
That was a great effort by the Tennessee team. They came in here with some rest, but also playing two teams that had a lot of momentum. Excellent coaching job. It's got to be a dream for him in his first year.
And I wouldn't know what to say about Kentucky, except it has been a tremendous way for the national champions defending to go out. They never quit. They were undermanned, worn out, but wonderful.
They've shown about as much courage as any team I've ever seen. As you say, undermanned, key player hurt. They've had to make changes. Only 8 scholarship players on the bench, but they've hustled every minute. They've done themselves very proud.
Bertelkamp, 74-69, Tennessee. It's all over. The Volunteers of Tennessee have won the first renewal of the Southeast Conference Basketball Tournament, the first renewal in 27 years. Tennessee's Volunteers 75, the Wildcats of Kentucky 69.
I think there were a lot of keys. First of all, in the first half, we did not effectively attack Kentucky's 1-3-1 zone. The ball was not going in for us. Consequently, we shot around 41%, while at the same time, our defense wasn't doing a job because Kentucky shot 65. We came out in the second half, we went to our full court dynamite press, and that turned the game around for us because we came from 8 points down and tied the game, went ahead, and then we played our tempo. I was so happy to see our kids come out in the overtime and get the lead. We deserve to go to the NCAA.
Your team won with class. Kentucky lost with class.
Yes, Kentucky's a great basketball team. They have great tradition, but Tennessee was just far better today.
Your inside game was very, very good tonight.
Thank you. You know, we worked quite hard to get the ball inside to Reggie Johnson, a real fine player. Chuck Threets helped us immensely. Howard Wood has been suffering lately with serious sinus trouble and lost a great deal of weight. Kevin Nash came in after 10 days off with a sprained ankle and helped us greatly. But overall, it was a team victory, and I'm just happy for our basketball team.
Coach, a great victory for you and the Tennessee Volunteers. Indeed, you deserve the crown. Good luck in the NCAA.
Well, thank you. We're going to do the very best we possibly can to represent the SEC and advance as far as we can.
Don DeVoe of Tennessee, back up to the booth.
And thank you very much, John Ferguson, for a splendid job courtside tonight. There you see some of the celebration. The Volunteers gaining their fourth Southeastern Conference basketball tournament title. It was 44-37 Kentucky at half, 55 all at the end of regulation play, and in overtime, 75-69, Tennessee over Kentucky. Getting set for the presentations down below. Tennessee now 20-11. The Wildcats end the season 19-11. Again to John Ferguson.
And to one of the all-star players of the tournament and clearly the leader for the Tennessee Volunteers tonight, Terry Crosby, 25. What a great game.
I didn't have too good of a game offensively. Some of my shots weren't dropping. When that happens, I just concentrate on defense. Try to do anything to help the team out. We got a couple of quick steals in early in the second half and brought us back. I'd like to congratulate Tim McClain for Kentucky. He's a great ball player, homeboy.
Well, he's wound up, I'll tell you for a fact.
That's right.
Good victory.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it. Hope everybody support us later on in the tournament. We're the Cinderella team.
Terry Crosby really added on the floor. Back up to Jay.
All right, it's a happy bunch of Volunteers. There they are, your Southeastern Conference basketball champions, winning this renewal of the tournament. And what a remarkable, remarkable week it has been in Birmingham. Day after day, basketball at its very best, Jeff Mullen.
Well, we've seen it from an opening tip. Great basketball games, many overtimes, going right down to the wire, and the teams battling. Here's our Nike All-Tournament team, selected by you and I, Jay, in the booth. We've got Bubba Price from Auburn, Reggie King from Alabama, Truman Clater and Kyle Macy, the two fine guards from Kentucky, and Terry Crosby, who I think offensively did an outstanding job, but did an outstanding job defensively on the tired Kyle Macy tonight.
And a $1,000 scholarship in those fellas' names presented by Nike to the general scholarship fund of the schools. The scene continuing here as the celebration grows in intensity for the Tennessee Volunteers.
Well, the Tennessee fans have come alive. Kyle Macy being presented with the award, I believe, as the most valuable player.
That is right. Macy had a remarkable tournament. You can see the consternation in this young man's face, the All-American from Peru, Indiana. But what a show he gave us this week.
A lot of minutes played, 93 points, most field goals ever scored in the SEC tournament, but most of all, leadership, a lot of heart, a lot of courage, great young guard.
All right, and back down below, John Ferguson.
And with Tennessee Chancellor Jack Reese and Director of Athletics Bob Woodruff, you men are very happy, I know.
Indeed, we are very, very happy.
And Don DeVoe comes in with a great victory in his first year for you.
Isn't that great? It's a great tournament. John, you did a great job. The team did a great job. Kentucky played a great game, too.
It's a great rivalry, isn't it?
It certainly is. 3,001 years, pretty good for the ball.
That's not bad. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much.
And to Knoxville, it'll be a happy drive tonight or tomorrow for the people of the Tennessee Volunteers, and now back upstairs.
And officially tomorrow, the NCAA bids will go out from the NCAA headquarters in Shawnee Mission, Kansas. And I think we've got Kyle Macy just about set down below to speak with John Ferguson.
We have Jay here is one of the very fine basketball players of the country, Kyle Macy, number four, Kentucky, an all-star player, an all-conference player, in my book, an all-American player. You had a great tournament, Kyle. Congratulations.
Well, thank you very much. We'd like to come away tonight. We gave him a good fight, but the ball just wouldn't go in when we needed it.
I commented during the course of the game, as Jeff and Jay did upstairs, that you fellas had played a lot of basketball, and so you, at times you looked a little jaded. You had to be tired.
Well, I think we were. You know, four games in 4 days, it wears you out, especially during the second half.
Were there any things that happened during the game tonight that led you to believe that maybe Kentucky had a chance or didn't have a chance?
Well, we're a great group of competitors, and we never give up. And, you know, we were in it right down the wire, but like I said, the ball just wouldn't go in when we needed it.
What were you trying to do there in the last few moments?
Anything we could to get the ball and score.
All right. Your guard around offense worked well?
Yes, it did. You know, we set a lot of picks in our offense and keep the ball moving, and just weren't there.
You had some great games, Kyle. Congratulations. A great effort on your part and the Kentucky Wildcats. I said a minute ago, Kentucky, loser tonight, lost with class. You fellas did a great job again.
Thank you very much.
Kyle Macy, Kentucky, back upstairs to Jay.
Thank you very much, John. Classy Kyle Macy. What a wonderful young man he is, and another year of basketball for him at Kentucky.
Yes, and of course, Joe Hall and his troops, their season may not be over. They've got a fine record, I believe 19-11 now. They have an opportunity for postseason play, but they'll also be out recruiting some young players to go along with this fine team that they've got. Our congratulations to Don DeVoe and his team. They did an outstanding job.
I was mentioning earlier the NCAA bids will go out tomorrow, and many feel that LSU may get an at-large bid from the SEC, of course. They came in here as the top-seeded team, but were upset. And this tournament provided just so much for us this week that I just can't say what a joy it was, Jeff, to be here with you. It really and truly has been super.
Well, I'll tell you, I've certainly enjoyed it too, Jay. And tournament basketball is great. Someone said during the week, basketball is designed for tournaments, and I truly believe it.
We can say it again, certainly. Well, we want to say to all of you who have been watching, we hope you've enjoyed it. The executive producers of the Southeastern Conference Tournament are Castleman D. Chesley and Richard L. Clouser. The tournament games have been produced by Guido D'Elia and directed by Billy McCoy, Brian Seip, and Jim Silman. Associate Director Reed Becker, our production coordinator Snuffy Smith, network coordinator Sue Devlin. And now we're showing you some of the names, in fact, all of the names of our marvelous crew who has worked here with us this week and brought you the sights and sounds of the Southeastern Conference renewal of their basketball tournament. Thanks to our sponsors, too, and to all the stations who have been with us through this tournament, to Hootie Ingram, the assistant commissioner, and, of course,